voters, what we have seen unfold in the past 48 hours is really unprecedented. Nationwide raids, 5 prominent activist lawyers or writers arrested on Monday morning. But by Tuesday evening, these five suspects had been put under house arrest by the Supreme Court, contrary to the Pune police's plans of getting their custody. Now, why do I say unprecedented? Why are we calling this tonight India's biggest criminal conspiracy? Take a look at what the Pune police case really looks like. What is it that they seem to be telling us about this investigation? Point number one that the Pune police says is that there is a plot to overthrow the government, the elected government of India. That these activists were involved in conversations, that they are chain mails that speak about and intend to overthrow the elected government. Point number two, we are given to understand that there is a letter that has been found, it's been leaked to the media, we all have it, that suggests that there was a plot to target the highest political office. This is the phrase, highest political office, that's also been used by the Pune police in a statement this evening. Point number three, about their case that they have formed here. The accused have links with the banned CPI Maoist organization. That their links with Maoist groups, banned groups, is what the Pune police says. It's one of its strong charge against these five accused. What's next? Why is it that this is such a big deal? They say that these people were sitting and discussing and writing to each other about funding, about radicalization of the youth, and even about sourcing weapons. That they had catalogs that they have found from their raids that speak about different kinds of weapons. Which is why I say that this is an unprecedented development. These are very serious charges, viewers. But let us really see how it all began. Now bear with me if you already know some of it or all of it. It is always good to really put things in perspective. So we're going to take you through a chain of events, the timeline, which we are calling joining the dots, just to get the story clear in our head. 5 people were arrested in June 2018. Rona Wilson, Sudhir Davle, Surendra Gadling, Shoma Sen, Mahesh Rao. The connection between them is the Elgar Parishad meeting that took place in Pune on December 31st, 2017. That was the common connect. Now what happens next? This controversial meet, the common connect, the Elgar Parishad meeting was held on December 31st. This was to commemorate the 200th anniversary of the Bhima Koregaon war. Many big names actually attended this meeting. Several speeches were given. The content of these speeches became a little problematic for our law enforcement agencies, or so we were told. We more connect more dots. One day after this incident is when the violence broke out in Bhima Koregaon. On 1st of January 2018, a 19-year-old class 12 student was killed in this violence. We move on. What happened next? These 5 activists were detained in June 2018. Their houses were raided before these arrests. That is when that letter was leaked to the media, the letter that we have, which shows that these people were actually having a conversation about targeting the highest political office. Threat to PM, that's what this letter is really known as. Pune police says they dug more information, they found the entire alleged mail trail. And the connection from Elgar Parishad that was funded by Maoist groups is what we're given to understand. What happens next? Second round of arrests. The first round happened in June. Second round happens in August end. Gap was several weeks here. After the letter mail trail revealed few more activists' names, 5 activists were arrested after these nationwide arrests. We are being told this is now a conspiracy against the country. They were planning to wage a war against the country. UAPA charges have been brought in, and the 5 names, big names, will now come up on your screens. So they're fighting back, these people. They've gone to the court, and today the Supreme Court has said that they will be under house arrest until Supreme Court looks into the further details of this case. So let's go across to Abhishek Manu Singhvi, senior lawyer, also a Congress leader, who was present in the courts today. He argued very vociferously against these arrests. Mr. Singhvi, we are being told it is a conspiracy that involves a plot against India's highest political office, that it is a war against the nation and banned Maoist groups are involved. Yet tonight we see that the accused are not in police custody, but they are under arrest, under house arrest. Can you explain to us why the top court saw merit in not sending them to Pune just yet?
First and foremost, I don't think it's open to you, me or a third party to question what a court does, except in the procedure established by the court, which is a final hearing next Thursday. Secondly, since the matter is sub judice, I don't want to go into detail on the merits. But I want to start by saying, Tanvi, that the very fact that the court stands up in the middle of a constitution bench to allow us to knock on the doors of the court, irrespective of merits, and then hears that from roughly 4:15, 4:30 to 5 o'clock, I think that is testimony to the court's concern about liberty of the individual. And I think that is really the point to be made if we don't go to the merits yet. Now, as far as your merits are concerned, I think these generalities are not supposed to prejudice or cloud the mind. A policeman at an investigative stage can say anything. Today, three facts stand out, Tanvi. Bhima Koregaon was about in December 2017. These people were not present. The Elgar Parishad was organized, among others, by two retired judges, one of the Supreme Court, one of the High Court. Their FIR filed for the last many months, 9 months now, does not have their names. Now, merely because they happen to be people with very left leanings or with a certain view on democracy which does not match your view or my view. Assume we both violently disagree with them. They are, one of them calls themselves a revolutionary poet. The other has worked in the villages of Chhattisgarh. The point is that deviancy is not punishable under Indian law or the constitution. As one of the judges put it, democracy without dissent is an empty shell. Therefore, the feeling is getting around that at this belated stage, and one more thing, Tanvi, if after 9 months you have direct evidence of flight risk, you have direct evidence of tampering, you have direct evidence that I am not cooperating with you, that you are calling me to the police station and I am not coming and giving statements. Those are the only three tests, flight risk, tampering and non-cooperation, which are relevant for bail. This is an FIR 9 months ago, 10 months ago. Then why this sudden sweep down arrest? We are only talking of ultimately if they are guilty, they will be convicted. That trial will take, trial has not started yet, it will take a few months, I mean a few years. Question is, how can you sweep down amongst five dissenters and three more who were raided, not arrested, who are known for their views, which don't agree with the establishment view, and arrest them? These are only, you know, straws in the wind. I mean, you have no evidence except the say-so, and now after we've got some order from the Supreme Court, the police and the authorities seem to be going to town. They're holding press conferences. They are clearly trying to cloud and prejudice the atmospherics and the ambience.
Sure, but Mr. Singhvi, this is not an average case. This has gone beyond allegations about maybe speeches that were meant to incite people. We are now being told about letters, mail trails, about catalogues regarding weapons and funding to various activities. Do you think then all of these claims that have been put out are made up?
At the moment, no. I will use words of studied moderation. As of now, as we speak, no evidence, much less hard evidence, has come in any record. If I have something in my bosom and you have something in your mind, that's hardly something which can be called hard evidence. The record is, whatever record is available, we do not have any record suggesting the direct or indirect involvement of any of these people in waging war against the state or overthrowing the state, as seems to be alleged on television. Secondly, the test today is a limited test that can these people be regulated sufficiently by, for example, surrendering their passports, by, for example, not traveling abroad, by, for example, reporting to a police station every week or every day, or is arrest the only way? Are you trying to have a chilling effect by having a swoop down one fine morning after 9 months, arresting five people, raiding three others, and creating a clear terror aura? Now, you know, have you seen the qualifications of these people? Have you seen the commitment of these people? I don't agree with many of them, to be very honest. I don't agree with many of them. But that doesn't mean that I will take coercive steps against them. One of them is a US citizen who gave it up and came here. Another is teaching at the Law University in Delhi, the National Law University. Many of them have PhDs or very high qualifications of a technical or a nature of similar nature, postgraduate. You can't just assume without some concrete solid evidence. And what has come apart from press conferences and trying to paint them black and calling them Jholawalas and being dismissive of them and just calling them urban Naxalites? These are pejorative words of a penumbrical nature. Apart from that, tell me what is hard evidence. You paint a dog, give a dog a bad name and hang him. What do you have by way of objective evidence?
But Mr. Singhvi, Varnon Gonsalves was actually arrested in 2007. In fact, I also am given to understand Arun Ferreira has also been arrested multiple times in 2007, in 2011. When he was walking out of jail, he was again picked up by policemen in regular plain clothes. In April 2014, Varnon Gonsalves was convicted under the Arms Act. So these are history sheeters. They have history. They've been arrested multiple times. We can't say they don't have a questionable past.
Tell me, these are in the public domain. The other person you've named has not been convicted. Both are out as free citizens today. Are you arresting them in 2018 on one fine day because of the 2007 offense? Please tell me that. Can you do that? And if you have a past, in most cases, not finally judicially adjudicated, are you entitled to lead a normal life and be entitled to bail and be entitled to all the courtesies available to a citizen? This is the whole point. You are painting them black because largely they happen to function in a sphere of civil society which you violently disagree with. And ultimately, nobody has answered yet the question, how is the absence of arrest going to be a threat to society? Let's assume that they are guilty ultimately in a conviction 3 years ago, 3 years later, which we don't know about. Let's assume that they are going to be acquitted and found innocent after 4 years. Today, on what basis is arrest justified is my question. At least till now, we have been given nothing to say with arrest. We have not been told that tomorrow they will run away out of India. We have not been told that they are going to be, in a manner with such a high scrutiny of media and or all of you, going to be in a position to tamper with any witnesses. We are not told that any of them has not cooperated in terms of giving a statement or being available for questioning. Then the question arises, are you not sending a clear message of fear? And is this the true test of a democracy? A democracy upholds its head high when it is faced with such terrible allegations, which at the moment appear to be mere verbal allegations.
Mr. Singhvi, do you find it odd that when the charges are so serious, literally about planning terror acts against the highest political office of our country, that the NIA or the ATS or the CBI haven't even been brought in, that we have a city police that is investigating this case?
I agree with you 100%, but let me make it sound more odd and more weird now that you've asked me. You just said highest political step. Now's the funny part. First of all, let me be clear, I tweeted yesterday, not today, that nobody in his right mind in this country will want to attack the country or its Prime Minister. He's our Prime Minister as much as yours, as much as everybody else's. Now, this letter which is bandied around is not part of any legal proceeding. It has not been filed by the prosecutor. It has not been... What is this shoot and scoot policy? You just give me a glimpse of something, then you hide it in your pocket. You just give a small teaser to a TV channel and then you only that TV channel has it and then everybody else doesn't have it. You just give a trailer to prejudice and create. Where is this letter? Where is the proof that this letter has anything to do with any of these five? And secondly, as you rightly put it, I mean, all hell would break loose at the highest level of NIA CBI, if something like a prime ministerial plot was found, which is a letter not used in the prosecution, by the prosecution in the proceedings which are at the moment pending in Pune. So, I mean, to put it funny or weird is a mild word. It is downright contradictory, it's fishy. Whether dal mein kala hai ya dal hi kali hai, I don't know.
Abhishek Manu Singhvi, thank you so much for joining us. He was present in court today. We'll all keep an eye out now what happens in the top court on September 6th. Thank you for speaking to the Mirror viewers of Mirror Now, Abhishek Manu Singhvi. Let's go across to our other panelists joining us this evening. Vineet Goenka, member of the Governing Council, Chris, also the former co-convener of the BJP IT cell. I also have Shailesh Gandhi, former Chief Information Commissioner, Aman Pawar, spokesperson for the Congress Party, and Biswajit Bhattacharya, former ASG. Mr. Goenka, you heard what Abhishek Manu Singhvi had to say, although my conversation with him was largely on the legal basis because he is present in the court and he presented arguments there. But what is your response to some of the points that have been raised, especially about the way this entire action has unfolded in the last 48 hours?
There are certain observations on his statement. Number one, few of these accused were arrested in 2007. Why were they arrested then? That time there was a Congress government in Maharashtra as well as in central government. If there was nothing wrong, why did they break the law that time? And why did the state fail that they had broken the law that time? A. So that has to be answered by him, which he conveniently did not answer. Then he also said if it was not proved and they should lead a normal life. It was not proved, that means there was a lousy investigation done that time, which the Congress has to answer, not me. A. B. Honorable Prime Minister of Congress and all of us, that time Manmohan Singh ji spoke in the house that this is the bigger threat than anybody else, that is Naxalites. They are now trying to do away with that. They have lost their big people like, you know, Vidyasaran Sukla ji, Ajit Jogi ji, by the attacks of the Naxals. Even that they are not considering. They have come to so low that now today they are funding and helping legal aids to this kind of anti-nationals. Let me take this opportunity to tell you, these are people, these urban Naxals are people who camouflage as intellectuals. They camouflage as good people, they camouflage as human rights activists, they camouflage as lawyers, but actually they are foreign funded mercenaries, nothing less than a jihadi. These are the people who are the link between the foreign funders and the innocent peasant who cannot even speak Hindi, but they give guns in their hand. Now the same people whom Manu Singhji was defending are talking about teams of 200 red flag activists to fight against the state. These are the same people who talked about breaking this country. I feel pity about this. They jump into helping this kind of people. Where were these Manu Singhji and other people who are trying to help them today? When Colonel Purohit was arrested, when Sadhvi Pragya was arrested, that time they said hang them without even investigation, hang them without even judicial process. And my last statement will be, trust in the court. If they are innocent, court will not hang them. If they are innocent, court will even ask the police why they were arrested in the first place. Mm-hmm. Let the court have their proceeding. Do not jump. And you see the battery of lawyers who jump today, and that tells us the lot. You know, I could see people who do not charge less than few lakh rupees jumping today to save these five or six people who are actually anti-national. These are the people who are trying to create ruckus in our country. And all of them jumped in the Supreme Court. None of them spoke. None of these good lawyers jumped when, you know, Sanatan Sanstha people were arrested 3 days back. None of them came and defended that they are also people who are trying to dissent. Actually, okay. Tanvi ji, this is not a dissent. These are people who are trying to create sedition under the camouflage of dissent.
Okay, so on the same this. Round, oh. since I no, actually no, am, I don't in believe in this
I'll
whole.
Just make one question.
No, I just want to point one thing out. I don't believe in this versus that. Where were you when this happened and where were you when that happened? And why do you have a different, why didn't you say anything then? And why are you saying now?
This is truth
no,
of the life.
There is no end
that
to that.
Truth of the life.
There is no this end is to that, Vineet Goenka. That kind of an argument can go
that's
on
why,
and on. But let me try it. Let me try it once.
I usually don't
resort to these kind of arguments, but I'm going to try this tonight. If that is your argument, then here is my counter question. Why aren't we bringing in our most experienced, the best, the agencies that are actually experienced in handling plots against the highest political office of this country, in handling letters that speak about threat and destabilizing of the government, of the elected government. Why aren't we bringing in the NIA? Why aren't we bringing in the anti-terror squad? Why aren't we bringing in the CBI? Why is the Pune police doing this job when we are being told that sections of terrorism have been brought in, that these are very serious charges, that it's not just about Bang Maoist groups, but they were looking at overthrowing this government? I am very, very concerned why this is being taken so lightly.
So let me tell you, this is Bharatiya Janata Party's central government and Bharatiya Janata Party's state government, which gives free hand to the agencies, be it the police or the law enforcement, other agencies, also the judiciary. That's why you see that somebody has been arrested yesterday, but the court said, okay, no, you cannot put them behind the bars, put them in the house arrest. This is because there is a free and fair democracy which is going on here. The police there in Pune are competent.
What is free and fair democracy?
There is a requirement of somebody else to come in.
Then why the National Investigative Agency and the anti-terror squad are there for a reason?
Please let me answer. This is a very serious national security threat.
Yes, it is. And it's a very serious national security threat, we are being told. But we are being told that the Pune police is handling it.
I'm sure you will allow me to complete
my sentence. And today we have a situation where these very serious charges against people, those people are not behind bars right now. They're under house arrest because proper case was probably not presented to the top court.
No, no, don't be happy. Don't be happy.
I'm not happy. I'm concerned.
Do not.
I'm concerned.
Wrong picture.
Who's presenting this case? Why are you not able to convince the top court about how serious this case is?
Ma'am, can you answer you? Can I answer you? You have asked me the question. Let me answer this question. You have asked me the question. Please let me allow me to answer this. A, court has not acquitted them. Court has not given them the bail. What court has said is, put them in the house arrest. Is this saying that the police have not done the good job? If the police would not have done a good job, and this would have been innocent people, court would have given them bail or asked them to be released immediately. So understand this. It is not something, and these are verbal comments been passed by the court. It is not a process
right.
paper which the court has given against the agencies. A. B. Let me also tell you, when there is a hearing which happens on the next Thursday, then see the evidences. And if that time also court says, okay, no, release these guys, they are not acquitted, then, you know, you can question the agencies which are there. Number two, please trust the police there. You know, the pain today is what? People believe the accused, but they don't believe the police. They don't believe the agencies which are there. They jump to conclusion as if they know everything on the earth. As if that you and everybody else knows that who should be the person who should investigate, who should be the court which
okay.
should take the trial.
Okay.
Let us believe the police there. They have
Aman Pawar, I see
and
your
it was
hand.
Not the guy Varavara Rao was not arrested in Maharashtra. He was arrested in Hyderabad where there is no BJP government. So understand this. These are the people who are national
Two
threat.
Points.
They have created ruckus. They fund poor farmers.
Okay, I'll come back to you, Mr. Goenka. I will come back to you. To Aman. Let me go across to Aman Pawar of the Congress
and
party.
I hope
yes,
Congress
Mr. Pawar.
Congress believes that
Firstly,
their own seniors were killed by this nationalist.
Yes, Mr. Pawar.
Firstly, this is not a question of any five individuals that have been arrested today. It is the larger question is the fear psychosis the Bharatiya Janata Party is trying to, insert in this country that anybody who does not subscribe to the ideology of the BJP will be treated in this way. We have seen this in Una. We have seen this with Rohit Vermula. And now the threat is such that even if, you know, a student or a youngster is trying to condemn or probably put a post against the government or the government of the day, even he is, compelled to live under those fear psychosis that you never know what are the repercussions going to be. Now, let me tell Mr. Goenka two things very specifically. One is that their own NHRC, the National Human Rights Commission, has issued a notice to the DGP Maharashtra that these arrests
it's not our own, it is government of the countries.
I am unable to understand. I am not able to understand, and I see this as hypocrisy of your party, Mr. Pawar. How are you making these tall claims today? How are you making these tall claims and standing up in defense of those very people that your government picked up, sent behind bars, that your government dragged to the court, and who were convicted by the court when your party was in power? Can I take you to the track record of some of these people?
Can I
tell you that Vernon Gonsalves was arrested in 2007? He was convicted in 2013.
Yes, he was arrested. He was arrested. He was tried
and
by a court
you
of
see
law. Men,
and today you
and
see,
then
and today you have
law
a problem.
Convicted.
Yes.
No, today the situation is today the situation is that if somebody is arrested, either he is branded as an anti-national or he is branded as an urban naxalite. That was not the modus operandi. If he was arrested, so he was convicted.
I don't care about these brands. I genuinely don't care about these labels.
They are not Congresses.
Just see the clear message. Kindly see the clear message the Supreme Court has sent. The Supreme Court has denied the Pune police any police custody of all these five people who have been who the police wanted to arrest today. They have been given interim relief by the Supreme Court and have been put under house arrest. However, the Pune police was witch hunting all of them.
This was
wanted
the
to arrest
Supreme
them,
which
the Supreme Court
questions
has clearly
few days back.
Told them not to.
I am just going to
the same piece.
Okay, I have to go across to my other guests. But Aman Pawar, here's a quick refresher for you. Aman Pawar, here's a quick refresher for you. 1 minute, 1 minute. Where are you going, Aman Pawar? 1 minute. No. Because you're going on this.
What I want to make is that the Minister of State, Kiran Rijiju, without any trial, tells the entire country that we have caught Naxalites. Who is he to convict them? The minister has already arrived at a conclusion that they are Naxalites.
Point taken.
And
point
the Supreme
taken.
Court is giving them interim relief.
Point taken.
Who is Kiran Rijiju to brand them as Naxalites?
But
anybody
here is a reminder for
the government is a Naxalite.
I have to move on to our other panelists. This is also for our viewers. I was reading.
They are anti-Indians.
I was reading the diary of one of these activists who was picked up and sent to jail several years ago when Congress Party was in power. Arun Pereira, in his prison diary, wrote, and this was published by the Open magazine in 2012. He wrote this in 2007-8. He said, I wasn't quite prepared to become a target of excesses myself by the state, to be arrested, tortured, implicated in false cases with fabricated evidence and locked away in prison for several years. I have many such more examples that we could go on and on, but that's not the point tonight. And so we're not going to dwell in the past. That was just a small thing I wanted to point out, that all political parties switch sides very conveniently. When they are in power, they have a different stand to take. When they are not, they have a different stand to take. Let's get back to the case as it stands tonight. Mr. G. Bhattacharya, thank you so much for joining us this evening, Mr. Bhattacharya. What's your view about what has been officially put out there? One letter that leaked, that made it to the headlines in many media organizations, that spoke about a threat to the Prime Minister, hasn't been submitted in the court. It wasn't even mentioned in the Supreme Court today when they were trying to get the custody.
At the outset, I make it clear that, you see, I don't know the facts. So having said that, my impression about arising out of today's Supreme Court proceedings is that this has been a gross abuse of power to arrest. The manner in which the police in our country are going on arresting people left, right and center, I think time is not far when the arrest jurisprudence in the country may have to be altered by the Supreme Court itself, and I will not be surprised if this happens in this case itself, because the Supreme Court, the Honorable the Chief Justice of India and two companion judges of the highest court have made strong observations that in a democracy, dissent is a safety valve. And my impression about Pune police is, just a few months back, Pune police traveled from Pune to Jaipur, went to the residence of retired chairman of Bank of Maharashtra, picked him up and took him to Pune, put him behind bars, and the person got a bail within a few days. Now, what is this happening in our country? India is a very strong country. Five persons, by no means five big persons or VIPs, from whatever little press information has come, I don't think these five citizens out of 1.3 billion Indians are strong enough to destabilize the mighty government. Remember kindly one thing, in India there are more than 600 districts. out of which approximately one third of the districts are afflicted with, if I may say, with greatest respect and responsibility, Maoist. So therefore,
yes,
the state has a far overriding obligation, to curb the Maoist actions across the length and breadth of the country. And it is coming. Two more very, very historic lows have come today in our democracy today.
Yes.
Today, rupee is at an all-time low of 70.59, $1. This is the historic low. That is not being talked about. Today, the demonetization has been a flop.
Exactly.
99.3% of the currency has come back. That is not being talked. Everything is being overshadowed by Pune police. By picking up these 5%, they may well be guilty, I don't know. But the question is, pre-trial arrest, when there is no possibility, I don't know, under three conditions one can arrest.
Right.
One, well, tampering with the evidence,
yes,
not cooperating with investigation, and fleeing from the process of justice. So therefore, in my view, this is a blatant misuse and capricious misuse of state authority, and time has come in our country,
right,
to judiciary.
Well, Mr. Bhattacharya,
I would really salute, I will salute the Supreme Court for at least for a few days,
sir,
thwarting the Pune police attempt to take them behind bars.
Well, Mr. Bhattacharya, let me tell you something.
House arrest,
sir,
as
if this
proposed
is an attempt to overshadow any other crucial issue, it's not going to work, not at least for Mirror now,
Tanvi,
because we
have
tonight itself discussed the RBI annual report,
Tanvi,
the impact of
demonetization.
We have repeatedly also highlighted the impact of rupee and what it really means for the Aam Aadmi, the soaring fuel prices.
I'm not talking about your channel.
Let's get back to the case.
The timing, this is an event of 31st of December last year. Like even the Honorable Supreme Court has stated,
well, in Pune police's defense,
so
Mr. Bhattacharya, in Pune police's defense, according to what they say today, and if we were to believe what they found
the
today,
without, no,
they were
no,
on
they
completely
well
different
guilty,
track, completely may, wrong track
well
for the
guilty,
first 3 months. For the first three months, they were chasing wrong guys, according to them.
Just to join Mr. Bhattacharya.
And in April end, they actually gave clean shit to those two guys.
To join Mr. Bhattacharya.
I'll come back to you.
I think he's bang on when it comes to this.
If they are guilty,
and these are diversionary tactics of the BJP government,
put them to trial.
Especially at a time when the Prime Minister himself has been accused of corruption in the Rafale deal. These are diversionary.
Mr. Shailesh Gandhi has been patiently
government
waiting for his turn, and I think we should just all give him his space to make his comments. Mr. Gandhi, thank you for patiently waiting by. I will go back to this one aspect, Mr. Gandhi, because it's really bugging me. This letter, this so-called letter that was written from one activist to the other and then came out in the media several weeks ago, it's again in the limelight. And I'm just going to read two lines from this purported letter between the two activists. It says, "We are thinking along the lines of another Rajiv Gandhi type incident. It sounds suicidal. There is a good chance that we might fail, but we feel that the party must deliberate over our proposal." And it goes on to details of what can really be done to attack a certain personality in our country. Point is, if this is really a real plan and this is a real letter and these charges are that serious, Mr. Gandhi, I don't understand why this letter is in my hands but wasn't given to the justices in Supreme Court today.
I think on this limited point, you are 100% right that this letter should have been in the Supreme Court if it is genuine, and this should have been brought up, and perhaps the NIA and the Intelligence Bureau should have been looking at this case, not the Pune police. I completely agree. But today I'm finding myself in the horns of a dilemma, Tanvi. My heart says, and because perhaps of my predilection, that these people who have been arrested wrongly and charged wrongly because they are human rights defenders. However, I'm asking myself, the Sanatan Sanstha, when police arrest them, I feel they are doing good. I think there is a problem here. We need to define our legal processes better. And Mr. Bhattacharya made out a great case saying these five people, great injustice done to them. Yes, but have any of us talked of what the fact that one third or more of those in our prisons, in our overcrowded prisons, are poor people who are there because of no guilt except that they are poor? So long as I continue a system like this, this will keep continuing. But on this, coming back to this, I genuinely feel if I cannot trust my police, if I cannot trust my security agencies, there is a trust deficit, and there is definitely a trust deficit. Even I have doubts. But then I ask myself, do I justify the Sanatan Sanstha arrest? I say yes. If I justify that, then will I say this is wrong? When I feel that these people are good, should I say that no, they should not be arrested? When I feel people are bad, I should say they should be arrested. What is happening with our nation? And what are we called criminals? Today, reports are published, and I'm sure all of you reported, saying 33% of our members of parliament are criminals. This is a terminology we've all got used to. Something is going wrong. We need to correct this. I feel I'm really in a on the halls of a dilemma. Usually I have clear views on something. Here, I see some merit in what Mr. Goenka is saying and some merit in what the Congress representative is saying. And I really believe all of us must look at this dilemma, ask ourselves. We have certainly a very poor criminal justice system, a dysfunctional criminal justice system. That is true. Today, because of these five prominent, and as you pointed out, they've been arrested before. If it was another criminal, he would have called a history cheater. We call our MPs criminals. But these five are holy cows. We must believe that they are right. I would like to believe, because my heart says, yes, they are the sort of people or the who are concerned with the backward, who are concerned with the disadvantaged. But by that, it does not mean anything. The fact that the Naxal philosophy is to use violence, and the fact that these people appear to be close to them, I am not very sure where the truth lies.
Yes. Well, to be clear about something, Mr. Gandhi, the situation is very serious, but most of us are not very clear where the truth lies, because not much has been officially put out there on record. For the first several hours yesterday, we chose to not, you know, harp on what was being told to us unofficially, because we wanted to know officially what were the charges that had been slapped against these people, why they had been arrested, what were the causes and what those sections were. That is something that we only found out officially this evening. And the Pune police finally came out after case hearings had happened in three different courts. So to be frank, there isn't much out there on record that is being told to us by the investigators. Perhaps they see merit in not doing so at this stage of the investigation, which is why we're just sticking to the bare minimum facts that we have so far. Vineet Goenka wants to come in, and then I will go across to Aman Pawar. Go ahead, Vineet Goenka.
I have some points to make. Mr. Bhattacharya never spoke about Colonel Purohit or Sadhvi Pragya.
That's not the point tonight. And how many debates we've had about that? Why do you want to talk about that tonight? No. Why do you waste our time by talking about issues which are not relevant tonight in this debate? I don't get that. How many times have we debated this, Mr. Goenka? Why can't we stick to the topic at hand?
So demonetization was related to this topic, you know, Rafale was related to this, and thank you for allowing them to speak on Rafale and demonetization, but you know, this is not related. Those guys who have been arrested earlier by Congress and let loose, they are not been arrested. And for his knowledge, Professor Sai Baba has been convicted and been given life, sir. These are the people who camouflage as intellectuals. They are actually enemies of the state, who get funded by foreign people, then they create birthdays of Asuras to just demean the Indian gods, which have been there for centuries. You know, these are the people who indoctrinate youths in the colleges also give guns in the hands of the workers and the peasants. Sir, tell me one thing, Bhattacharya ji.
You have evidence of that?
Peasant,
why isn't the police presenting
Hindi?
Evidence of that to the court? If they had presented this
is
evidence
Mr.
to the court.
Mr. Bhattacharya has an evidence of how they are innocent? Does Mr. Bhattacharya have an evidence of that they are innocent? Do you have an evidence that the police have not done a proper job? Do you have an evidence that the police have not done a job properly? Please allow me to speak, madam. By curbing my voice,
you
could not prove
Mr.
this anti-nationalist to be right.
Why are you so frustrated?
I am trying to make a point, madam.
I know it pains.
I'm not frustrated and mental.
I know
sir,
it pains,
you are
Mr. Goenka, when,
party
when,
who's, you know,
when the freedom of speech
who
is taken away.
So please,
I know it pains,
you
Mr. Goenka,
no right to speak on
when
this country.
Freedom of speech
Let
is taken
you
away.
Thing.
Go
Let
ahead, have your say.
These are the people. Yeah, I'll tell you one thing. Dissent cannot be camouflaged. This is sedition, nothing else than that. Madam, they cannot insult us. They cannot interfere in the people there. How come a Bastar farmer gets gun, madam? How come they get a training? There is somebody middle between them and the foreign funding. And these are the same Naxalites who are actually moist. And if the courts have to do justice, there should be a fast-track courts and they should be hanged if they are found guilty.
According to you, Rohit
Nirmala
was also an
them.
Naxalite.
These are the people who are trying to break.
Yes, Mr.
Sir,
Pawar,
I never said that. That
saying?
Is your belief. According to you,
Rohit Vemmula is also not the point of debate tonight.
Those who were lynched,
Rohit Vemmula lynching cases are not the point of debate tonight. Aman Pawar, can we stick to the point?
Even you may have disowned.
Jayant Sinha goes and garlands the lynching accused.
Sir, let me just
Aman Pawar, Aman Pawar, I am going to reiterate what I just told Vineet Goenka. If you two want to have a say on this panel, can we stick? Can we stay
right?
to the topic?
To see this? You know,
I'm going to go across to Biswajit Bhattacharya.
Aman Pawar ji, 2007.
My simple point.
Biswajit Bhattacharya, please.
My simple
you see
point
this?
Is
these are the people arrested
the
by you, sir.
Today.
You see
yes,
this?
BJP
eight people arrested by you, sir. Please tell me why did you arrest me?
Nobody is able to understand either of you two. Mr. Goenka, can we put the audio down of both the gentlemen, please? Enough. Mr. Goenka, you are an experienced panelist. You've been on my show so many times. We don't do this. Let's show the way to Aman Pawar, who was making his debut on Last Word tonight. Let's please hear each other out. Now, Mr. Pawar, if you have a point to make specific to this case, let's do that. I don't want
Mr.
to go
Pawar
down the road of Rohit Vemmula or lynching.
So unfortunate.
Let's talk about this case. It's very serious, these charges.
I don't
charges.
Think he'll let anyone speak.
Go ahead, Mr. Pawar.
Yes, my only point here is that it is very unfortunate that the Minister for State for Home Affairs, Mr. Rijiju, and the panelist here and the entire Bharatiya Janata Party have assumed the role of the judge, the jury, and the prosecutor and have declared them to be Maoists before any court trial. Whereas I think, you know, the conditions in
which
the Bharatiya Janata Party
talking,
is targeting those who are speaking against them,
spoke exactly
who are
like
speaking
Rahul
against
Gandhi.
Them, there is an emergent
like
need for the Supreme Court to lay down guidelines. There is an emergent need for the Supreme Court to lay down guidelines for arrest in this country.
Okay.
Because this is an
I'm running out of time.
Of
I actually, that was a very good
Today
point that Shailesh Gandhi
to
raised.
It could be
and I just want to hear Mr. Biswajit's view on
there
this.
Were, earlier, there were journalists, there were... There
yes,
media
in fact, this should have been done long time ago
government.
During Congress's term as well.
This
the party, that party that actually brought in the current version of UAPA
country.
Actually has the audacity today to turn around and say we need to bring about some changes. The sections that are being used today were actually brought in by the Congress party. Mr. Bhattacharya, your view, do you agree with what Shailesh Gandhi says that we need some more reforms in the way these things are done?
Absolutely. In fact, my expectation and hope today has basically risen, arising out of the observations of the Honorable Supreme Court. And I am sanguine that in this case itself, it's my hope, it's my expectation that the highest court of the country will rise to the occasion and firmly propound that every innocent, every person is presumed to be innocent till proved guilty, number one.
Yes.
Number two, be you ever so high, law is above you. The prosecuting agencies, the police are not above the law. They should not be permitted to behave as if they are law unto themselves there has to be an accountability. I'm not saying that somebody is guilty or not, but if somebody is guilty, put him to trial, let him face the trial, let him be convicted and then go to jail.
Yes.
This pre-trial custody power is being abused mercilessly in the country. It's time to draw the line.
Okay, I'm completely out of time. I'm going to thank all of our panelists for joining us. Thank you for taking your time out. To the point that was made towards the end, here is some more information of what happened in Delhi High Court that adds to it. Now, what did the Delhi High Court question today when it was deciding on the custody or the transit remand of one of these accused? They said, why were relevant documents related to arrest not translated? Effectively saying that the documents were in Marathi and they were not translated, so the magistrate couldn't really take a call on this custody. And that became a huge flashpoint. Questions were raised. The Delhi High Court observed every minute that a person spends in custody is a matter of concern. Then they questioned the credibility of the witness. They say that the witness should be either a family member or a respectable member of the locality. The police can't bring along its own choice of a witness and go through all these formalities. So serious questions were basically raised about the way these raids and arrests were conducted. And I think it's not just this case. In our country, thousands of such incidents take place every day. These cases, such arrests, such raids are conducted every day where the method can be questioned, and that needs to be fixed. As far as this specific case is concerned, the charges are very, very serious, viewers. But the Supreme Court has seen merit right now in saying that these five activists accused will be in house arrest, will not be taken into custody by the Pune police until we look into the case deeper on September 6th. They have issued a notice to the Pune Maharashtra police and to the Maharashtra government. We keep a close track of this case. It was heartening to see the observation that was made by the Supreme Court. And so I will end this show by reiterating what Justice Chandrachud said, that dissent is the safety valve of any democracy. Thank you for joining us tonight.